Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss previous year GATE question. Previous year GATE question number 27. Let us read the question. An electrodynamic type wattmeter have large errors while measuring power in AC circuits at low power factor conditions. Since the voltage across and the current through, and they have given the four options: current through the current coil are not in phase, current through the current coil are not in quadrature, current through the pressure coil are not in phase, and current through the pressure coil are not in quadrature. Okay, so if you recall, in a EDM type wattmeter, we are having error is equal to sine of delta minus phi minus cos phi, okay, divided by cos phi. Okay, sine of delta minus phi minus cos phi divided by cos phi. Okay, and here delta minus phi is nothing but the angle between current coil and the pressure coil. So delta minus phi is the angle between current coil and pressure coil. Okay, so if you check, therefore error comes into the picture when they are not in quadrature, right? So if delta minus phi is not equal to 90 degree, because if delta minus phi, okay, is if delta and phi, okay, will be equal, then it is like sine of delta minus phi. Okay, it will be sine 0, so it is a 0. Okay, so error will be minus cos phi divided by cos phi. So error will be minus 1. So error will be maximum. Okay, so here if delta is equal to 90 degree, then it is sine of 90 minus phi. So it is a cos phi minus cos phi. Okay, so it will be 0. So if delta is 90 degree, okay, then it is like, yeah, error will be if delta is not equal to 90 degree, then the error occurs. Okay, so here if you check the options, the correct option is option B, means the voltage across and the current through the current coil are not in quadrature, right? So are you getting the point? Okay, so friends, this is about the previous year GATE question number 27. Previous year GATE question number 28. Let us read the question. The circuit in figure is used to measure the power consumed by the load. Okay, so this is the circuit they have given. Here we are having a wattmeter. The wattmeter current coil resistance, here wattmeter pressure coil resistance. Okay, load is having a unity power factor load. Okay, the current coil and the voltage coil of the wattmeter have 0.02 ohm and 1000 ohm resistance respectively. The measured power compared to the load power will be, okay, and they have given the options: 0.4% less, 0.2% less, 0.2% more, and 0.4% more. Okay, so if you check here, we know, yes, the error in the measurement is due to the power consumed by the current coil resistance. Okay, so first of all, can we find the true power? Yes, so here true power, that is the PT is equal to true power, which is equal to, we can write it as V into I into cos phi. Okay, so what is the voltage? It is a 200 voltage across load into current flowing through the load. It is a 20 into cos phi. Power factor is unity. Okay, so if you check, it is 200 into 20, so it will be 4000 watt. This is a true power. We are having PT, right? So true power is 4000 watt. Okay, now if you check here the measured power, okay, the measured power PM is equal to measured power, okay, which is equal to, either we can write voltage across the pressure coil, okay, into current flowing through the current coil into load power factor. Okay, so voltage across pressure coil or potential coil, you can write voltage across pressure coil into current flowing through the current coil, that is the ICC, into load power factor, that is the cos phi. Okay. So if you check, voltage across the pressure coil is nothing but the voltage across the current coil plus voltage across the load. Okay. So you can write, what is the voltage across the current coil? It is a 20 I into R, that is according to the Ohm's law. Okay. So 20 into 0.02. This is the voltage across the current coil. Plus, what is the voltage across the load? It is a 200. Into ICC, current flow through the current coil. It is a 20. Into power factor is 1. So we can write it as 20 into 0.02 plus 200 into 20. So it is 4008. So measured power is more than that of the true power. Okay. So they have asked the measured power compared to the load power. Okay. So we can find the percentage. Okay. So therefore, error is equal to measured power minus true power divided by true power into 100. So we can write it as 4008 minus 4000 divided by 4000 into 100. So if you check, it is 0.2%. Whether it is a more or less, more. Because measured power is greater than that of the true power. Okay, so if you check the options, it is a 0.2% more. So option C is the correct option, right? So friend, this is about the previous year GATE question number 28. This question is from GATE 2004 examination. Previous year GATE question number 29. Let us read the question. A wattmeter is connected as shown in the figure. The wattmeter reads. They have given the options like 0 always. Second option is total power consumed by Z1 and Z2. Third is power consumed by Z1, and fourth one is the power consumed by Z2. Okay. As we know, the wattmeter reading is equal to voltage across pressure coil into current flowing through the current coil into cos of angle between. Okay, cosine of angle between VPC and ICC. Right? So, so now here if you check, here we are having the wattmeter's current coil. Right? Here it is a wattmeter's potential coil. Okay? Suppose if we neglect the current flowing through the potential coil. Okay? Means if we consider the resistance of the potential coil is to be infinite, because they have not mentioned anything about the current coil resistance and the potential coil resistance. Okay, so suppose if we neglect this resistance or the power consumed by the potential coil. Now, if you check, if whatever the current which is flowing through this branch, that is the ICC, the same current will be flowing here, ICC, because here current in this branch will be zero, because here we are having the infinite resistance, right? And potential coil of the wattmeter generally having a high resistance. Okay, next, the current coil is connected here. Okay, so ICC is nothing but current flowing through Z1, which is equal to current flowing through Z2. Next, if you check the potential coil connections, one terminal is connected here, the second terminal is connected here. Means indirectly, can we say that the potential coil is connected across the Z2 only? Okay, so here we can write potential coil voltage is nothing but VZ2. Okay, and current flowing through the current coil is nothing but ICC, which is equal to IZ2, which is equal to IZ1. Okay, so we can write it as VPC is equal to VZ2 into current flowing through the current coil, that is the current IZ2, or you can write IZ1, because as this resistance is infinite. Okay, so that's why whatever the current in the Z1, the same current will flow through Z2. Okay, into cos of angle between ICC and VZ2. ICC and VZ2. So if we check here, Here VZ2 into IZ2 Z2 into cos of angle between ICC is nothing but IZ2 and VZ2. So it is like a power consumed by the Z2 only. Okay, so which is equal to power consumed by Z2 only, because we are having voltage across Z2, current flowing through Z2 into cosine of angle between current flowing through the Z2 into voltage across and voltage across the Z2. Okay, so if you check the wattmeter, you will read the power consumed by Z2 only. Are you getting the point? Okay, so friend, this is about the previous year gate question number 29. Previous year gate question number 30. So let us read the question. For the circuit shown in the figure, the voltage and current expressions are V of t is equal to E1 into sin of omega t plus E3 into sin of 3 omega t, and I of t is equal to I1 into sin of omega t minus phi 1 plus I3 into sin of 3 omega t minus phi 3 plus I phi u into sin of phi omega t. The average power measured by the wattmeter is, and here they have given the circuit and also they have given the four options. This question is from GATE 2012 examination. Okay, so let us first note the given data. It is given V of t is equal to E1 into sin of omega t plus E3 into sin of 3 omega t. I of t is given, which is equal to I1 into sin of omega t minus phi 1 plus I3 into sin of 3 omega t minus phi 3 plus I phi u into sin of phi omega t. Okay, so if you check, V of t consists of, this is the fundamental component and here it is the third harmonic component. I of t consists of, this is the fundamental component, this is the third harmonic component, and this is the fifth harmonic component. Okay, so we are having, here the frequency is omega, here frequency is 3 omega, right? So this will be your fundamental component E1, and here E3 sin of 3 omega t is the third harmonic component. I of t, this is the fundamental component, this is the third harmonic component, and here it is the fifth harmonic component. Okay, now as we know the power, let us first find the power for the fundamental. So P1 is equal to, yes, it is a V1, that is a voltage of fundamental into current of fundamental, that is a I1 into cos phi 1. So we can, which is equal to E, V1 is nothing but RMS value of the fundamental voltage, RMS value of fundamental current, and power factor of the fundamental voltage and current, or the cosine of angle between V1 and I1. Okay, so as this is the RMS value, here E1 is the peak value of the fundamental. Okay, so we can write it as E1 by root 2 into, yes, I1 is the peak value of current of the fundamental, right? So here we can write it as I1 by root 2. So it is V1 by E1 by root 2 into I1 by root 2, okay, into cos of angle between these two. Here angle is only omega t. Here it is omega t minus phi 1. Okay, so we can write it as cos of phi 1. Okay, plus, sorry, this is for the fundamental. Similarly, we can find for P3, that is the third harmonic. It is a V3 into I3 into cos of phi 3. What is a V3? V3 is the RMS value of third harmonic, which is equal to E3 by root 2. E3 by root 2. Okay, into I3 is the peak value. So we can write as I3 by root 2. Be careful, this I1 is the RMS value of the fundamental current, and this I3 is the RMS value of the third harmonic current. Okay, so I3 here is peak value. So we can write it as I3 by root 2. Or in order to remove the confusion, I am writing it as small I1 and small I3. Okay, so into, what is the angle between these two? It is a phi 3 only. So it is a cos of phi 3. This is the P3. What about the P5? Is equal to V5 into I5 into cos of phi 5. 5 5. Okay, so if you check what is the V5 in the V of t in the voltage, the fifth harmonic component is not present. Okay, so it will be 0 into current, it is a I5 by root 2 into cos, right? As the fifth harmonic component is not present, so angle will not be available. So if you check, this will be 0 only. Okay, so therefore we can write the power P. Okay, the power P or the average power, that is the P average, which is equal to, we can write P average is equal to P1 plus P3 plus P5. What is the P1? E1 by root 2 into I1 by root 2 into cos P1. Okay, so it is equal to E1 by root 2 into I1 by root 2 into cos P1 plus what is P3? E3 by root 2 into I3 by root 2 into cos P3 plus 0. Okay, so we can write it as, it is like root 2 into root 2, 2, root 2 into root 2, it will be 2. So we can take one outside, 1 by 2, okay, into E1 into I1 into cos P1 plus E3 into I3 into cos P3. Okay, this is the P average, right? So if you check the option, it is 1 by 2 E1 I1 cos P1 plus E3 I3 cos P3. So option C is the correct option, right? So friend, this is about the previous year gate question number 30. Previous year gate question number 31. Let us read the question. Power consumed by a balanced 3-phase 3-wire load is measured by 2 watt meter method. Okay, so here we are having a 2 watt meter method. The first watt meter reads twice that of the second. Then the load impedance angle in radians is, and they have given the 4 options. Okay, so it is important that they have given first watt meter reading, that is the W1, is twice that of second, that is 2 into W2. Okay, so W1 is 2 times W2, it is given. Okay, so now as we know, in a 2 watt meter method, the angle phi, that is the load power factor angle, okay, is equal to tan inverse of root 3 into W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. Okay, so here can we replace W1 with 2 times W2? Yes, so we can write tan inverse of root 3 into W1 is, we need to replace with 2 W2. Okay, so it is a 2 into W2 minus W2 divided by W1 plus W2. W1 is 2 W2 plus W2 as it is. So if you check, it is equal to tan inverse of root 3 into W2 upon 3 W2. Okay, so which is equal to W2 will get cancelled. So it is tan inverse of root 3 by 3. So it is like 1 by root 3. Okay, so if you check, tan inverse of 1 by root 3. Okay, so it is equal to pi by 6 radian, or in degrees it is a 30 degree. Okay, right? So the final correct answer is option C, pi by 6. Right, very simple question. So friends, this is about the previous year gate question number 31. Previous year gate question number 32. Let us read the question. While measuring power of a 3-phase balanced load by 2 watt meter method, the readings are 100 watt and 250 watt. The power factor of the load is, okay, so here it is given that W1 is 100 watt, W2 is equal to 250 watt. Okay, next, as we know, the power factor angle phi is equal to tan inverse of root 3 into W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. So if you check, it is equal to tan inverse of root 3 into W1 minus W2. So it is 100 minus 250. divided by 100 plus 250. Right, so if you check, this angle will be 36.58. okay, so angle is 36.58, right, minus actually, okay, so it is a degree. So phi is minus 36.58 degree. So what is the power factor? Cos phi. Therefore cos phi is equal to power factor, which is equal to cos of 36 point or minus 36.58 degree. Okay, so if you check, point eight zero three. Okay, so power factor is 0.803, right? So the final answer is 0.803. Okay, very straightforward question. It depends on, we need to recall this expression. Okay, we already derived this expression. Okay, so friend, this is about the previous year GATE question number 32. Previous year GATE question number 33. Let us read the question. And low power factor wattmeter of power factor 0.2 is having three voltage settings, 300 volt, 150 volt and 75 volt, and two current settings, 5 ampere and 10 ampere. The full scale reading is 150 watt. If the wattmeter is used with 150 volt set voltage setting and 10 ampere current setting, the multiplying power factor of the wattmeter is, okay, this is a numerical answer type question. Okay, so let us first note the given data. We are having the low power factor wattmeter with a power factor of 0.2. okay, so we can write LPF wattmeter power factor is equal to 0.2. okay, next, potential coil voltage setting, we are having the 300, 150 and 75. Okay, so potential coil voltage setting, we can write, which is equal to 300 volt, 150 volt and 75 volt, right? Next, current coil current settings is equal to 5 ampere and 10 ampere, 5 ampere comma 10 ampere. Okay, full scale deflection is equal to 150 watt. Okay, that is the, we are having the watt meter which is 150 watt low power factor watt meter with a power factor of 0.2. okay, so we are having watt meter is, we can write it as 150 watt LPF wattmeter, okay, with a power factor of 0.2, with a power factor of 0.2. okay, next, so wattmeter power is nothing but VI cos phi. So we can write V into I into cos phi is equal to 150 watt, right? So therefore we can write VI is equal to 150 by 0.2 because power factor is 0.2. So if you check 150 by 0.2, so it is a 750 volt ampere, right? 750 volt ampere, right? So if, therefore we can write scaling factor is unity when the voltage and current settings are, which are the product will be matching to 750 volt ampere, that is, so we can write scaling factor is unity when voltage and current settings are, yes, we are having the different settings. Okay, so if we use 150 volt and 5 ampere, then the scaling factor is unity because 750 volt ampere, right? If you take the product of these two, this will be the 750. Okay, or we can have 75 volt and 10 ampere. If we use these two settings, okay, then the scaling factor will be unity. Okay, so because here it is a 750 volt ampere we are having. Okay, are you getting the point? We are having the three different voltages, okay, and two current. So if you check 150 into 5 and 75 into 10, that will be your 750 only. Okay, so if you use these two settings, definitely the scaling factor will be unity. Okay, now if it is used with 150 volt voltage setting and 10 ampere current setting, okay, if used with 150 volt voltage setting and 10 ampere current setting okay, then the meter reading, okay, the meter reading must be multiplied by two, because yes, we are having 150 volt into 10 ampere, so it will be 1500 volt ampere. Okay, so actually it is 750 volt ampere, right? VI, right? So therefore for 750, if we use these two, then 750 it will be unity, and for 1500 it will be 2. Okay, so therefore multiplying factor is equal to 2, right? So friend, this is about the previous year gate question number 33. Thank you.